So where are we going with this Monday morning? I'm just going to take a swipe at Ole Gunnar Solskjaer just for the sake of taking a swipe at Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. But Pogba says something needs to change. Ole says, yeah, something's got to give. So what is the something? These two were talking about that very topic.
I think it's all of us. We need to find something. We need to change something. I don't know if it's the mindset of all of us, the players, when we start. We really don't know. It's frustrating because it's something that we don't understand, and we have to find out very fast, because if you want to compete and if you want to win the title, it's those games that you have to win.
One result in isolation, it can be, say, luck, margins, but then we've got too many games now that we've lost points, so we need to look at the whole setup of the team, whole balance of the team. Maybe something has to give.
Well, he knows that. Pogba knows that. But what is the something, Danny?
Very simple, Jim. It's called work rate. It's called commitment to the cause. The reason they don't have it is there's a tactical issue. There's too many attack-minded players on the pitch, which is the manager's fault. And there's no repercussions for those players who don't put it in. You watch United play, yes, there's moments of brilliance. There's some great football. They've got lots of creativity. But they're too easy to play against. I mean, Villarreal, they made Villarreal look like Brazil, 70 team. You know, Villa, loads of chances, loads of possession going, or Everton late in the second half causing them problems. Too easy to play against. I think they've had one clean sheet all season.
So it's work rate. Work rate.
Well, when you
Pogba's not working hard enough.
Jim, they're 17th in the Premier League on Opta stats for more than a one-man press. Right? Very simple equation. The stats don't lie.
But everybody said this at the beginning of the season. If certain people were going to be patronised, as a matter of course, because of the innate superstar ability that they have, this was going to be the casualty of it. Graham Souness said it at the very outset. If Ronaldo's put in the team, they won't press teams. They'll become victims of that particular challenge, and unless they're going to be constantly better than everybody else. Because what is the logic? Put aside my feelings about whether Ole Gunnar Solskjaer is an elite manager. By having an offensive side and that being your only setting, what kind of management is that? It doesn't take a rocket scientist to realise that teams in this division are very capable and they can play around people that don't have presses.
So if you don't have a press, normally what you do, if you look at a team and you go... You drop deep,
yeah,
and you play counter.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at United's results against the other big team, the big five, the big six last year, they had some really good results. Because he went into the game with a mindset, I'm going to pick a team here that's got work ethic, it's pragmatic, and we're going to drop in and condense space and play on the break. And that's why they got results against the best teams, because they went into the game with a defensive mindset. Look, I'll try and simplify it from my point of view.
So what's changed now then?
Because when they play the teams they think they're better than...
Well, Leicester beat him in the cup semi-final last
year.
They
think you don't. Man United players walk on a pitch against Leicester thinking they're going to beat them.
Sure.
When they play Man City, they're a bit.
But they don't.
No.
In recent history.
Yeah. So that's where the manager has to come in and kick some backsides and go, "You're not doing it, so I'll put him in."
What did you make of Pogba's post-match interview?
Strange.
Yeah.
If you haven't got strange, if you haven't got an answer, don't do the interview. Yeah. But if you look and bring it back to football, we'll get to the management, I suppose, in a minute. But from a footballing perspective, most managers simplify it when they're coaching you. And what they do is they talk about the number of defensive-minded players in your team and number of attacking-minded players in your team. Liverpool have won the Champions League and the Premier League playing a 4-3-3. I know the fullbacks fly forward, but they're defenders primarily. They have three attackers in the team. And two of those three work like dogs. Salah's probably the only one who gets away with not tracking back as much, which is fine because he wins you most games.
Yeah.
Chelsea won the Champions League playing a 3-4-3. The only three players who attacked on the pitch, really, were the three forward players, and even though put a shift in. Because if they didn't, he'd swap them. Italy won the Euros playing a 4-3-3. Three attacking players. Seven defensive players in the team. France won the World Cup doing it.
Yeah.
Bit lopsided.
So how does he skin this particular cat then?
Well, he has to sacrifice one of the attack-minded players, play three midfielders who run and get around the pitch more, and put a shift in and do the hard yards and press more and run back more and do the things that most midfielders do.
So what does that look like then?
Well, it doesn't look like Matic and Pogba.
Right.
When you play a Leicester side that have got Tielemans and Maddison popping it in and around. I mean, people go, Fred McTominay. I'll tell you one thing about Fred. He never leaves anything out there. He comes off that pitch, you know you've got it all. Now, he's not United quality, I'll take that.
But Dan, is it not slightly worrying that Manchester United need another team like Leicester to show them how to do it?
No, they didn't.
Work rate has to be the bare minimum.
Well,
the bare minimum. These guys are earning fortunes, and you're saying they're not working hard enough.
Well, no, they're not. But you don't have to. You don't have to work hard another. Or you don't always have to work harder than the other team to win football matches if your tactics are good. Okay, so when Leicester won the league, they didn't necessarily run more than a lot of the teams they beat because they sat in and played counter.
Yeah.
So it's not all about running stats. You can get obsessed with running more than the other team. But what you can do is not be 17th when you're in your stats on pressing when you're Man United. You should be going after teams at Old Trafford and destroying them with the quality they've got. So there's a tactical problem. My question is a simple one. I used it last night. I don't mind using it again because, I mean, Simon's brought it up on this show, but it's a very, very important question. Would a different manager have different results at Manchester United? Would they have got over the line in any of those competitions last year? Would they be better defensively now? Would they be harder to beat? Would they be a more, what's the word, realistic prospect? Would they be a more realistic prospect, right, proposition of
so
winning
the
league?
So if Klopp was in there, would they be harder to beat?
If Pep or Klopp was in at United now, they would be in a better position than they are. There's no doubt in my mind.
So Ole's not good enough?
And Tuchel.
So he's not good enough. He doesn't rate with those three, is what you're saying.
No, I've wanted him to in a way because I like him, but he's not capable. And the thing is, if you look at Tuchel in the last 3 weeks, you know what he's done? Because they had a couple of bad games where they lost a couple of games. He's not just changed personnel and gone, you fix it. He's actually gone to a five in midfield, three centre midfielders who are all defensive, right? Loftus-Cheek sitting. Kovacic, Kante, and play two strikers. He's only got two attacking players on the pitch. And then look at his bench. He doesn't care who he upsets. We're going to not stop losing games because I'm not watching that again. We'll play two up front and the rest of you keep us in the game.
And you're saying Ole doesn't have the backbone
to do
that?
Not the United way. Keeps talking about the United way. The United way is winning first, good football second. Yes, if you can get both together, great. But United way isn't losing all the time. That's
so
not the United way.
So who does he sacrifice then?
Take your pick. But what you can do is you can make a start by going, I'm going to play three in midfield and I'll leave three attackers on the pick, whatever formation you want to make that happen.
Well, he can take one out. He can't sacrifice Ronaldo.
I said a year and a half ago, Fernandes and Pogba in the same team doesn't work unless you've got eight others who are workaholics. You throw Ronaldo in the mix and in effect, you're carrying three, aren't you?
You've got 30% of your team you're carrying, yeah.
So, and it's fine to carry three attacking players if the rest of them know what they're doing behind them.
Right. So the something is, Pogba says, we need something. Ole says, we need something. The something is?
Work. And repercussions of performance.
Simple as that.
If you don't have repercussions of performance, you won't get the work.
But that goes to the heart of management, doesn't it? The repercussions of performance come from the manager's outlook and disposition. When you listen to a manager who is a very decent human being and a very decent football manager, but we're talking about elite guys that want elite things, the language that you don't hear is when a journalist turns around and says, what do you think of that? He said, well, what do you think of it? That's a default setting that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer referred back to a journalist. Well, what do you think is wrong with it? The bottom line is he will get Manchester United to a decent level because he's got decent players. But if Man United fans are happy with that, who are we to say they shouldn't be? I have always said that to be able to be at the top of the Premier League, you need a top of the Premier League manager. And Ole Gunnar Solskjaer doesn't fit that bill. And with the group of players that he's got, if there's no repercussions, if Danny's right, and he probably is, if there's no repercussions to performance, then the management structure, the management style, and the management outlook is completely flawed. Because there has to be, managers have to be brave. They have to have to be definitely right or definitely wrong, but definite. And what is moment in time he's trying to do is manage and be everything for everyone. And being nothing to all of us.
Yeah. So four of the next five for Manchester United, Liverpool, Tottenham, City and Chelsea, they're about to enter an absolutely crucial phase of the season. And this something, Danny says, is simple enough. Work rate. One of you from Manchester United fans on that. 08717 223344.
Jim White and Simon Jordan, Monday to Thursday morning, 10 till 1. On AM, on DAB, via the talkSPORT app and on your smart speaker. talkSPORT.